Mr. Imus in a bit of trouble this morning. Getting coverage all over the place, man. All over the place.
What do you think? Fired or so completely fired?
I don't know what to think of this one. I don't know. I don't know. Because I think... The first time he screwed up, I still don't see it. Sorry, I don't. Yeah. They've been playing that clip all morning long. We're not allowed to play it on radio, even though we're trying to discuss this like a news station would discuss.
Yeah, they play it on the news.
But if we play it on our radio show, they'll dump out of it, and then we'll have to have a meeting, and who needs that when you want to get, you know, out of the city right after the show? But I don't know. I think this one, if he's explaining it one way, but... I think this is worse how can I explain this, Patrice? Help me out. Like he said, well, let's just play it. We'll start.
All right.
This is what Imus said yesterday.
Defensive back Adam Pac-Man Jones, recently signed by the Cowboys. Here's a guy suspended all of 2007 following a shooting at a Vegas nightclub.
Well, stuff happens. You're in a nightclub, for God's sake. What do you think's going to happen at a nightclub? People are drinking and doing drugs?
Yeah.
There are women there, and then people have guns. So, anyway, go ahead.
Well, he's been arrested six times since being drafted by Tennessee in 2005.
What color is he?
He's African American.
Oh, well, okay, there you go. Okay. Now we know.
Well,
there you go. Well, there you go.
Now, he's claiming that he said that because, well, they're arresting him a lot because he's black.
I think he's being sarcastic. I hear a lot of sarcasm, especially in that first part where he's talking about, well, you know, what do we expect? You go into a club and people are drinking and there's girls there and guns, or you're going to have shootings. What's the problem? Like he's doing this whole as a matter of factly kind of a, hey, yeah, the club? Well, of course, there's going to be gunfire. What are you, crazy? And then he goes into the thing. What color is he? He's black. Well, of course. Sure he is. What? Like I catch a lot of sarcasm in what he's saying here. But I don't think it's going to be picked up like that, especially with the likes of Al Sharpton.
Right. Patrice?
I'm not sure, man.
I'm kind of there with you. I'm right in the middle.
Like, you know what?
Like the first thing I always do is put myself in a bad spot. I put myself in the spot of the dude that's not trying to get fired.
Right.
He's a dude, he's an old man trying his best not to get fired.
Right.
The old school incident, he was not an old man trying not to get fired. So you know there, he's probably not going to make a racial, it's possible he was trying to say, well, they're bugging him because he's black. That could have been an indictment on society.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I know that's going deep.
It's amazing. They're spinning it that way immediately. They've already put out a statement that said that's what he meant.
Like, well, he's black and people are going to bother him because he's been arrested six times because he's a black guy that hangs out at bars and he's a professional athlete. They're bothering him. If I had said it, I don't know if that would have... They might have took it like that. But, again, he has a history.
A history, yeah.
I say this. The Democratic nominee for president of the United States is a black man. So anything goes now. I'm just going to say whatever he wants. Screw it.
Here we go. Here we go.
Why do you get to pass?
And we're off. In this corner. And here we go. It only took 40 minutes today.
I'm kidding. Come on.
You will be exhausted like I will.
No, I'm teasing, of course.
The point I guess I was trying to make, if with Imus's history, like Patrice said, why wouldn't you make that perfectly clear? Like, wouldn't you have a filter in your head the whole time? Like, oh, my God, I almost got fired for being... You know, a racist, blah, blah, blah. I just said this controversial thing. I know I meant because he's black.
Right.
He's getting arrested and they're bothering him a lot. Maybe I should tell people that after that statement.
Mm-hmm.
But he's like, there you go.
Imus is not, look, again.
I would have made it perfectly clear is what I'm saying.
80?
He's about George Carlin's
age. He's an old guy.
Yeah.
And another thing, this is all I'm saying is just like, you have to believe that he's a complete liar to not, you know, accept anything. I can't believe he's dumb. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But he's an old man, and sometimes you ever have inner dialogue where where you're just not listening to anything but yourself, and then you have a quiet conversation with yourself, and you're sitting there like the dude is reading the thing, and he's on, and then he goes, oh, you get shot at the, because he goes, what's wrong with going to the thing there? And then he's like, in his mind, he's just still going, boy, was he, in his mind, this is a question he asked himself. What color was he? What color is this guy? And evidently he don't know who the hell Pac-Man Jones is to even ask what color Pac-Man Jones is.
You know what? He knows who Pac-Man Jones is. Do you think Imus knows and knew he was black before he even asked that question?
He worked on a sports station for too long not to pick up a thing.
So if he knew that black Pac-Man Jones was black,
he had to have known.
Then there could be an issue.
To have known. Because like us, I mean, you know, you're reading the papers in the morning. So, I mean, if that was the story of the day, there's probably a picture of the guy. Come on.
Yeah. I'm trying to figure out immediately how it can't be racist in certain situations.
Yeah. Kind of trying to.
And that's the thing about the damn president, again, why I want a black president, so that I can allow white people to have an opinion about a black president.
Well,
black presidential candidate. Right now, if white people have an opinion about him, I just immediately go, you're racist. Well,
right.
I'm as discussed this already on his show. We're getting the audio. So he discussed it and he's moving on, but we'll play what he.
Really?
What
he's moving
meant.
On. Well, wow. A lot of balls there to just move on in, Mr. Imus.
Move on from this whole thing here.
Let's move on. I said I'm sorry. He apologized like a black woman.
No.
I said I was sorry.
We got Imus in the studio here.
What is, what color is he?
Black.
Ah, that's right. He's a. Yeah. I gotta bleep myself because, sometimes I say stupid things, and I get the all up my. So I gotta watch what I say.
Yeah.
Pac-Man.
Mr. Imus.
Pac-Man was yellow, not black. Yeah. Yeah, baby. Yeah.
Mr. Imus.
Yeah.
Reverend Al Sharpton's gonna have a statement in the next couple of days. He's gonna look into this. This latest faux pas.
He could kiss my black ass is what he could do. Yeah. Oh, shut up, jerk.
You don't have a black ass.
No, he does. Big fat ass. That's what I call him. At home with the doors shut. The lights out. Soundproof room. I have my room that I go into.
Is that known as...
It's the room that I just go into and scream that word over and over again.
Well, other people would call it a panic room, sir.
It's completely soundproofed.
Yeah.
And after every day, I go in and just scream the word over and over again as loud as I can. Yeah.
In your panic room.
Yeah, my panic room.
Because if you said it in public, there'd be a lot of panic.
Yeah. I do call it the room, though.
Yeah, I understand. No. I'm just cleaning it up for you so you don't get in more trouble.
It's Imus. It's not Anthony. You can't get in trouble doing this voice.
You're speaking of characters.
Yeah. Oh, that's pretty funny.
What?
Does my garage say dead Pac-Man storage? Because storing dead Pac-Man ain't my business, Jules.
Wow.
It's going to happen if my wife comes home. I'm going to get divorced.
Yeah.
I don't want to get divorced. You got to call some people.
You're on Pop Culture. A movie from what? How long ago was that movie? Let it be known that the black man is feeding Imus some lines for this bit.
Oh, what?
You. Thank you.
No, it's fine. It's I'm quoting Pulp Fiction.
Oh, all right.
Yeah, baby. Take your foot off the... that Quentin. He uses that word a lot.
He likes that word.
Certainly does.
Jesus Christ. I think you like that word too, Mr. Imus.
Yeah, I love using it.
Yeah.
So I go into my panic room. It's a panic. Never invited anybody in there. And I yell that word so loud and so clear. Mm-hmm. And I have a few pictures up in there. Reverend Al.
Right.
Yeah, and I yell at him all the time.
Mr. Imus, this is a great line coming in from Steve from Bayshore, but I'm too scared to even say it.
Really?
Because they're listening to us right now. But, you know, Pac-Man is a video game.
Yeah.
Old school video game. There might be another old school video game out there that we could reference with
that? Donkey Kong.
Well, I wasn't going
to How's
say
your Donkey
that.
Kong? I used to say that all the time. How's your Donkey Kong?
Right.
Yeah. I did hear that Reverend Al is very upset with me, and he's going to be throwing barrels at me.
No, he's not. That's not what he does.
No? Sorry. I apologize for that.
Yeah.
I'm sorry I said that. Come on. There's some coming in that are just completely off limits.
Of course.
God, I hope Obama wins. I can say all this stuff. Free reign? What do you think?
Not at all.
No, not at all.
No.
You don't see those mainstream media using the N-word?
Oh my God, what are you
going
crazy?
Going back to just saying it instead of, you know,
Hell
saying
no.
the N-word?
Hell no.
It'd be much worse.
All right, listen, we got to take another
break. Much worse.
Yeah, we're going to get the Imus explanation after the break.
Yeah.
We got Patrice O'Neill sitting in for Jim Norton today. Are you promoting anything there?
I'll be at the Houston Improv on July 4th, 5th, and 6th.
You're doing the improv tour.
Houston, Texas?
Houston, Texas.
Be careful. They don't like down there.
What, they don't like Pac-Mans?
Yeah, that's what I meant. I'm sorry I said that. I apologize that I said that.
All right, I'm just explaining his.
I'm sorry, I did that.
His misstep.
No. Well,
Warren and I were talking yesterday about Pac-Man Jones being arrested 6 times, and which I think was just, you know, it was obviously the picking on him. So I asked Warner what.
But see, he didn't make it obvious. Like, obvious that they're picking on him. What's obvious about that?
Mm.
Right?
That's what
he didn't explain himself yesterday.
No.
So I asked Warner what color he was. Well, obviously I already knew what color he was. That's what the point was. In order to make a sarcastic point, I asked Warner what color he was. Warner tells me. I said, well, there you go. That's the point.
Exactly.
Yeah. What people should be outraged about is that they arrest blacks for no reason.
Oh, God. I missed it.
No reason. What did he do? He isn't he up on, like, legitimate charges?
Jeez, man.
Isn't Pac-Man Jones a problem?
Yeah. Pac-Man Jones is
isn't he a problem?
No, what I was saying is
Pac-Man Jones. I mean, that whole strip club thing was insane. Like that.
Yeah.
A bouncer ended up paralyzed, and he just Pac-Man ends up. But again, it's that thing in this country where supposedly you're alleged. It's alleged.
Right.
He's never gone to jail for any of it. He's not doing time. He's been found not guilty for these things, but still, you kind of, you know.
I love the fact that if what Imus is saying is true, is he was trying to kiss some black ass
That's
right there.
That's what I
and
hear.
And it's biting him, and he's being accused of being racist.
That's what I hear.
He's trying to, yeah. I'm just saying, they put too many black people in jail. That's what I'm saying. I'd let them all out. I'd turn the keys and just, let every black person that's in jail, let them out. That's what I'm trying to say. Why didn't they understand that?
Imus, would you bang a black girl?
What does she look like? What color is she? I'm in Anthony's camp on this one. Yeah. I'd have sex with a black girl, of course. I'm going to be divorcing my wife and marrying a black girl now. It seems that's what I have to do to keep out of trouble. Yeah. Jerk.
The rap sheet on Pac-Man. July 13th, 2005, arrested and charged with assault and felony vandalism after a nightclub altercation. This began Pac-Man Jones' NFL rap sheet. He already had a lengthy one from high school and college. September 5th, 2005, Adam was invited to attend the Nashville Sports Council kickoff luncheon. Jones went off on a verbal tirade while being told to wait for his car after the event. He then refused to tip the valet service. What's the big deal about that?
Refusing to tip is something, you know.
But those type of things is... Imus could get out of this... If those type of things where it's like, that's ridiculous, that's racial to even report something like that.
Right.
It goes on and on. Let's see.
I think Imus will skate on this one because
he can absolutely defend himself by saying, look, I was saying, you know, it's not like his prior comment, which, you know, you couldn't take it any other way.
What?
Well, with the
are
people.
You crazy?
No, with the people that are against Imus. Like, I knew he was telling a joke, and it was all stupid and silly and everything. But this one, even his detractors have to agree, like, okay, he could have meant this.
All right, let's move on with the Imus audience.
They arrest blacks for no reason. And, I mean, there's no reason to arrest this kid six times. I mean, maybe he did something once, but, I mean, everybody did something once. Well, I have. And that, but, I mean, that's just...
And when does it simply become harassment?
I didn't. Yeah, exactly.
They
shoot blacks for no reason.
He's all flustered, man.
Oh, they shoot blacks for no reason.
Oh my God, Imus is trying so hard.
Imus is now the voice of the black man.
I'm now a black man. I'm officially black. fight the power.
I hate to say this. It's like, even if you after this guy and hate him, you go, he's just groveling.
I'm groveling here, people. Can you hear me?
Jesus, please don't fire me. That's what.
Yo, Patrice, my.
Hey, Don, what's up?
They're harassing us. You know, I was driving home the other day. I got pulled over by the man, and he said, "Get out of the car." And there was no reason. I wasn't doing anything. It's just because I'm black. It's the only reason I get pulled over and harassed like my black brothers. I mean, what did the kid do?
You hear he's talking about him like he's 10 years old and he stole some gum. It's involved in shootings? What's going on?
Let's go back to the Imus audio.
Yeah.
Shoot blacks for no reason.
Oh, boy.
We know about that in New York City. I mean, we already understand all this. So, and that in light of, I'm thinking,
can I translate
his
this?
Oh, is he trying?
Mouth is drying up.
His
mouth is drying up.
We've been at this a long time. Can I translate?
Oh, please.
Please just let me keep my job.
Look, I just got this job. Could you just leave me alone? I say stupid things.
I hear panic in his voice. I hear dry mouth, like Patrice said.
But what has he been talking about before this?
Let me tell you what a hero Rosa Parks was.
Like, well,
yeah.
Before this,
I love
mix
that
up,
woman.
He's been back on the air since November or something.
Yeah,
like that? What has he been talking about? This is his new problem. What has he been talking about? Muffin recipes?
Been talking about anything but race.
Oh.
Yeah. First time it comes up.
Obama, he avoids that. He avoids. It's like,
look, I love peanut butter, and if it wasn't for George Washington Carver, we wouldn't have any. He was the master of the peanut. And I just want people to recognize that George Washington Carver was a great man.
Well, what about Harriet Tubman, Don?
Harriet Tubman ran the Underground Railroad and brought many slaves up to the North, where they were then freed with that Frederick Douglass guy with the big beard. Yeah. Big white beard, might I say.
But that's before Die.
Yeah. Before Just for Men.
Kevin from Long Island writes, the funny thing is, for the last hour, Anna's been saying he doesn't find black women attractive. Imagine what would happen to Imus if he went on the air and said that.
I just don't find black women attractive. Yeah. Now, I'm outraged. Why don't you find black women attractive? Because no matter what they look like, I always picture you, Reverend Al, in bed. You've ruined it for me. You've ruined my experience that I could have some jungle fever. Because I just look at your face now, no matter how the girl looks.
You big dummy.
Hey, dummy.
We have time to do more Imus audio? All right. Let's try to get through this audio.
Red Fox is great, man.
We're running out of shell. Here we go.
And that in light of, I'm thinking, that's this current edition of the Imus Morning Program, in which, I guess if you can't see it on RFT TV, you don't know, but the producer of the Imus Morning Program, Tom Bowman, is black.
Oh my God, is he? Oh, I love him.
He's in complete panic mode.
Oh, God. The producer, you can't see him.
He doesn't even realize this apology just it's right up anybody's alley who wants his life. Like, he's just selling it down the
river.
Yeah.
Just stop.
This edition of the Imus in the Morning program is run completely by black people.
You had a good run. Like, go out like a soldier. You blubbering. I'm sorry, Don. Oh, yeah. Stop.
I'm kind of with you, Patrice.
Stop. Exactly. Stop.
If this was the street, I'm taking your money every day. Every day I'm going to take your money. Every day. Give me your money. Come here, man. Come here. You got a what? A black what? Come here, man. Give me how much money you got? How much money you got? If I check you and you got more than I find, I'm going to smack you in your face.
All right. Here you go. I'll see you tomorrow.
Don, how much money you got on you? How much?
I got $385.
You sure? Because if I check you and you got more, I'm going to punch you in your face.
Here's $516.
Is that it? Look at me in my eye, Don.
Yeah.
Is that it?
Okay, $832 is yours.
All right, look, man.
I have it all here in my pocket. My pockets are empty now.
Yo, shut up, man. I'm going to see you tomorrow.
Okay.
All right, I'm going to let you keep your job.
I'm sorry I did that.
But you owe me. Now, you should rather die. Not even, like, does he understand? Like, it's like, will you stop blubbering? Yeah. Stop being a little bitch.
Yeah.
Stop.
Yeah.
So, I mean, we already understand all this. So, and that in light of, I'm thinking, that's this current edition of the I'm Just Morning program in which... I guess if you can't see it on RFT TV, you don't know, but the producer of the I'm Just a Morning program, Tom Bowman, is black.
I was telling Patrice during the break, whenever a white guy is accused of being a racist,
yeah.
our defense right away is, what are you talking about? I got black friends.
I know this.
I hang out with black people.
Guys.
And did you see, it sounded like he made a... And he's black, and then the music's going to went, dun, dun, dun.
Oh, all right, you want to do it that way? All right, hold on a minute. We can do that.
The way he said it was so...
All right. We can do that. Give us a second. A little Austin Powers you need?
Bam, bam, bam.
You got it over there, Ed.
In case you didn't know.
Hold on.
This current edition of the I'm Just Morning program in which, I guess if you can't see it on RFT TV, you don't know, but the producer of the I'm Just Morning program, Tom Bowman, is black.
Let me one more time.
What are you doing, Imus? That's the best you got. I got black friends.
The producer.
Current edition of the I'm Just Morning program in which, I guess if you can't see it on RFT TV, you don't know, but the producer of the I'm Just Morning program, Tom Bowman, is black.
And you know, Tom is over in the booth rolling his eyes this old gag.
I got to be the fall guy.
Yeah, thanks a lot.
I wear a Kentucky Fried Chicken apron every day. What's the matter with him?
Producer.
What's the matter with him?
You got one more in you?
Sure. Right. Let's try this one.
I guess if you can't see it on RFT TV, you don't know, but the producer of the I'm Just a Morning program, Tom Bowman, is black. Two of the co-hosts, the cast members of the program, are black.
Careful. Oh, my God. He's good.
We have 8 black listeners.
And I'm wearing black socks today.
Jeez.
Anyone?
It's black. Two of the co-hosts, the cast members of the program, are black. Carol Foster and Tony Powell. What? How?
He's stuttering.
Oh,
Don.
Man.
Oh, because he knows Reverend Al is just rallying the troops.
I have a black army with me.
This saying, what doesn't kill you makes you stronger, but that is a complete farce. He should just go, he should learn from the old thing. It's like, no matter what he does, they're going to, this is awful.
This
is awful. Why don't you watch Usual Suspects, Don, and stuff? What, Kaiser Sosa killed his whole family so nobody will hold him hostage. Like, why don't you stop?
Let's get to the end of this.
Sosa.
Let's get to
that was a badass.
That's you held my family hostage? Why don't I just kill him?
I'll kill him.
And then we won't have a deal. Kill yourself. Kill your black co-host and your black producer and stop groveling.
Oh, damn.
What's the matter with him?
Let's get to the end of the clip.
Yeah.
Well, the cast members of the program are black. Carol Foster and Tony Powell. How insane would I have to be? What would I be thinking? What would I mean? Well, why would I sit here and say, "Oh yeah, there you go"? I mean, how does anybody? How do you make that connection? I mean, I know there's some people.
Wow.
My tires are black on my car. I just want to let people know that.
That's how George Bush explains Condoleezza and Colin Powell when he's done. Condoleezza, one of my highest rated is Condoleezza.
Great Secretary of State Condoleezza Rice, so I could do whatever I want.
Make it an apology. You've never heard Bush, as racist as people think he is and awful, he's never really made an apology.
Why would he have never said,
blah, 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 blah. What is the matter with...
I got Mexicans. I got them all.
And finally, I misended with this.
I mean, I know there's some people want to get me, but this, you're not going to get me for this. Is ridiculous.
Uh-oh.
You know what it reminded me of, man? It's like what? Joe McCarthy, the 1950s witch hunt. I mean, they're looking for something, and there's nothing there.
He should just say, please stop. This ain't fair.
Yeah.
Please stop.
Stop it.
He's begging for mercy.
Please. No fair. No fairsies.
Oh, God, man.
It is a witch hunt, though, because they're all over it today on the news.
It's ridiculous that's top story news.
Don Imus say something racist again? That's what they're doing. Mm-hmm. So he's got to get on the air. Everyone I know now is black.
I'm sick of us doing like black. We should just be doing something else. We have nothing else to do but wait for Don Imus to mess up?
Yeah.
Like, get out of here. Pac-Man doesn't care. He's smoking weed and robbing somebody right now. Laughing at Don Imus. He's like, wow, that white boy's sticking up for me. That's cool.
And Don Imus is just like, just give the man your money. What are you? Why are you resisting? Let him rob you.